On the good trip. Lollipop. Da-da-da. Damn, forgot the words.
It's okay, Caleb. They'll come back to you eventually. Anyhow, hey there, y'all. This is Lightning Bolt Forever, back with more blood. Fresh supply. Last time, we made our way through the Frankenstein-esque laboratory, and now we have come across the breeding grounds. But before we get into that, as you heard a second ago, Caleb was singing there, and when you leave him sit still for about a minute or so without moving him around or turning him or anything, he will start singing various random show tunes and popular songs to himself, as you heard. But yeah, it's kind of a funny little Easter egg there, and the songs differ depending on what level it is. So it would be hypothetically a different song in the next level. But anyhow, we'll proceed on forward here. We'll grab the first official Tommy gun of the episode, but we'll get the Tesla cannon out here. And we've got a nice water tank, and check it out. We got super armor and a secret compartment back there, which of course we will be getting to. Gotta get our secrets. And now we will head on around, with our spray can, and we will ignite some bloated butchers who are beckoning us to join them. But instead, we will burn them. Nice. So right here is a good spot to use our newly acquired weapon, and the last new weapon of the game, the Life Leech. So, let's get these guys' attention here, these hit scanners. I'm going to let them come forward a little bit to demonstrate this thing. And that's how it works. Yeah, it'll incinerate enemies, and if you do enough damage to them, it'll melt the flesh right off their bones there. Pretty neat. So, splendid. Very nice, very nice. Beautiful, beautiful remote bomb there. So we'll run inside here, grab all the items. We'll use the Life Leech a little more in here on the gargoyles here, since the gargoyles have been known to be weak to fire. So yeah, the Life Leech here is known, it goes by a couple of names, the Life Leech, of course, and it also goes by, some nicknames for it include the Hell Staff, the Soul Staff, or the Skull Staff, and it fires in bursts of 14, ooh, nice, that's what I wanted right there, it fires in bursts, how did this guy get in here? Come down there, will ya? Come on. I know you want to come down. Well, anyhow, it fires in bursts of 14 shots. And it fires them all at once here. So, yeah, like, that's me, like, just pressing the fire button once, not... Ah, nice. That's me just pressing the fire button once, not holding down the fire button. But anyhow, that one gargoyle back there, he'll be chasing this guy down. And this guy will drop the skull key, so we'll grab that. And that gargoyle serves as a pretty good hint as to... Whoa. Pretty good hint as to what you're supposed to do in this area. Now, before we move on, though, we've got all these angry fishies right here. So why don't we just kind of gather them all up here? Let's pool them up. No pun intended. And, let's place a few of these babies down. Why not, right? And that is how you... That is how you silence the water there, using a couple of using the build engine to your advantage there. All right, yeah, the explosions will clip right through the window, and it'll get all the aquatic guys out there. So, yeah, send him flying. Nice, got them both. Alright, good looks, fellas. Anyhow, let's run around and grab up all of our items. We need the eye key for this door, and the eye key for this gate down here, and spiders in the basement. We'll be back. Let's go upstairs. Whoop. Is this guy... Oh no, I guess I got him already. Anyhow, let's go through here. Zap the hellhounds. Just kind of... Yeah, save a little bit of our Tesla ammo there. Anyhow... Right here, we'll pick up another trapped soul, these skull guys screaming in the blue orbs there, and we'll let's use it on the zombies here. Now, the Life Leech, as I mentioned previously, has, well, it has a little bit of an interesting history behind it. As I mentioned, it was changed, or as I mentioned at the end of the... I always forget these guys are here. It was changed between versions of Blood. The function of it was. In version 1.0 of Blood, in the original version, the way the Life Leech would work was, as its name would suggest, it would drain the life of enemies and give it directly back to Caleb, which was a pretty neat feature. And when you ran out of ammo, it would just work like every other weapon. You would have to put it away and use it again, or you wouldn't be able to use it again until you found more trapped souls. But in version 1.1 and onward, including fresh supply here, the Life Leech now, instead of giving health to you from enemies, it actually, when you run out of ammo for it, we'll just grab up everything here, we got some gargoyles outside. Instead of doing all that, what it does is once it runs out of ammo, it will immediately start draining your health for more power. And I don't really, even then, I don't really use the Life Leech a whole lot in that regard, even if I run out of ammo for it. Here, I want to, yeah, do the alt fire with the Tommy gun there. I don't use it a whole lot just because, really, you gotta preserve all the health you can in this game. This game's already hard enough. But, yeah, it's kind of interesting how it came to be when Monolith was conceptualizing the Life Leech, and, by the way, move this turnstile for a secret upstairs. Here's another one in here with a doctor's bag. When they were developing the Life Leech, they wanted to replicate a weapon that had the same sort of effect as the Stone Gargoyle's blue lightning ball attack. So the Life Leech, especially now, it's interesting because it incinerates enemies by dealing spirit damage, and here's what the turnstile opened up, secret with a life seed. Yeah, watch this. See how Caleb's health kind of went down there? I'll do it again. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It drains your health whenever you run out of ammo for it, which is why you want to keep as many trapped souls, it's why you want to find ammo for this thing as much as you can. Ooh, nice. Whoop, got them all. Ooh, we got gargoyles. But yeah, that's basically how it works. But when they were developing the thing, because it does spirit damage, if you have an abundance of spirit armor on hand, and you by chance don't have any ammo for it, you won't do as much damage to yourself if you have more spirit armor, because it will drain your spirit armor too, in addition to your health, if you don't have ammo. Anyway, this just goes back to the starting area with the Hellhounds. But that's basically how it works. And it's a pretty neat weapon. Again, it's not my, I wouldn't say it's my preferred weapon. It's not the strongest weapon. But it does have a really cool alternative secondary fire. And it's useful for saving ammo for your other weapons. But we'll just burn those guys for right now. And don't grab that napalm launcher just yet. Instead, we got, hey, buddy. We'll just let this Gilbeast come up here. We'll get rid of him. You know, they're actually kind of cute in, like, a crazy, twisted way. But we'll get rid of all those guys. Well, I guess, well, now we'll get rid of all of them. And just run on out here. Just ignore the gargoyles. They'll chase you, but they ain't gonna hurt you. Grab up all the items. Leap up here. Now I'm going to try and get these guys to swim in the water. Oh, go down in there. Yeah, come on. I want as many of these guys to just dunk themselves in the water as much as I can. Come on. Oh, you know you want to go for a swim. Yeah, there we go. But careful not to get clawed by them here. Alright, you know what? Oh. Okay, that works. I am fine with this. Well, yes, in here is the super armor secret with another diving suit. You know what's strange is that there's three diving suits in this level. Ooh, hey fellas. There's three diving suits in this level, and you really don't need 3 diving suits in this level. You need them in the next level. Speaking of that. But anyhow, get rid of all them, jump on in. And we will... There we go. And we'll just keep on swimming. Yeah, see, here was the area with all the angry fishies. We were in there before, and we just clipped right through the window and got them. But anyhow, boom! 3rd diving suit, and that's it for the breeding grounds. So, yeah, it's just gonna keep ramping up from here in terms of difficulty, because next time is the Charnel House, and I will see you then. So until then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I'll catch you later. Thank you.